Good morning, everyone. We are starting a new chapter here today in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, Simin Kuf Samech Zayin 167, chapter 167, and it's Hilchos Avodas Kochavim Mazalos, the laws of idol worship. Now, although that we don't live in a generation where there really is rampant idol worship, we'll see as we go through this that there certainly are halachas over here that are very pertinent to our times. Says the Kitzur, Elili Masur Ba'ana, an idol is forbidden to get any benefit from. He v'tashmisha v'noya v'tikruvusa. And that's referring to the idol itself, the accessories, the adornments, and if they would bring offerings to the idols, that's also going to be prohibited to get any benefit from. And if anything gets mixed in, or these things get mixed in with anything else, even if there's one part of idol mixed into something that is 1,000 parts permissible items. So let's say, for example, you have some adornment or an accessory that was used for idol worship, and it gets mixed in now to 1,000 gold rings. So in many cases in halacha, we have something called bitul barayv, which means that even if something usur, something prohibited, falls into something, some kind of item that is permissible, as long as the majority of the objects that are there now are permissible, so we say that the one that is usur, that is not permitted, that becomes batal, that becomes nullified. For example, let's say that you have a pot of chicken soup and a drop of milk falls inside of there. So really we know that basar v'chalav, that mixing milk and meat, is something that is prohibited. You're not allowed to benefit from that and to eat that. It's treif, it's not kosher. However, if 1/60th of milk fell into this pot of chicken soup over here, that means that there's 60 more times chicken soup than there is milk. So the milk is bottled, the milk is like nullified, and it doesn't exist, and therefore the pot of chicken soup is 100% kosher. You can eat it with nothing to be concerned about. Over here, though, when it comes to the laws of Avodah Zarah, when it comes to the laws of idol worship, the prohibition of idol worship is so severe, it's never nullified in such a case. Which means, even if it will be mixed in one part idol worship into 1,000 parts of something else, not only is the little piece of idol that's still in there, is that usur, but it renders the entire mixture into something that is forbidden for benefit, and you cannot partake of anything right now. So again, if that one little piece of the idol fell in there, or the accessory, the jewelry, whatever it might be, fell in there, so and you can't see which one it is anymore, the whole thing is rendered usur as a result of that. Secondly, elilim shalevi kachavim, the idols that are being worshipped, v'chein tashmisha v'noya yeshlan bitul, so too the accessories and the adornments, they're all subject to something called bitul, that they could be nullified on their own. Again, not when they're mixed in with something else, but on their own, you can actually nullify them. What does that mean? K'shemevatel oisa ha'akum b'yadayim, if the non-Jew himself would nullify the idol and his accessories by doing something to it. What do you have to do? That means by doing some kind of physical damage to the idol. For example, let's say that the idol is in the shape of a human being. So yeah, if you cut off the nose of this idol, you are showing shalosei oid avodezar or tashmisha oy noi lavodezar. You're showing then that you no longer desire that this idol should be used for being served, whether you should get any benefit from it, because why else would you cut off the nose? Why would you cut off its arm? Why would you cut off its foot of this idol? Why would you put damage to it? So the fact that you're doing that, the non-Jew himself did it, and he did it for the sake of destroying the idol, therefore, says the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch Chutra, then it becomes permitted to be able to have some benefit. You could use it as your paperweight on your desk right now. You have the Buddha over there, who seems to be somewhat of an idol. Well, I guess we'll have to see if, in fact, it's going to meet all the qualifications. This little fat man over there, and he's an idol, which would mean that a person's not allowed to derive any benefit from him. But if you'd cut off maybe an inch of his stomach, or you'd cut off his nose, or an ear or the like. So then he would end up being permissible to have in your house. You could get benefit. You can use him as the paperweight or a door stopper if you want to. Then there would be no issue over there. Okay, we have much more to see over here. Again, like I said, although we don't see idol worship rampantly going on in the world, nevertheless, there are a lot of places where we will find that these halachas are pertinent in our lives as well. Have a wonderful day.